So I assume you're interested in lithium batteries because either way you want to change from your conventional existing lead-acid-based battery bank towards lithium technology, or you're building a new system from scratch and you want to base it on lithium batteries. You might be wondering whether the conventional hardware that interacts with your batteries, such as your inverter chargers, your solar or wind chargers, your battery monitoring system, etc., if it needs to be specifically designed for lithium, and whether or not you need to adjust the settings inside of the equipment. Well, in this video, I'll give you an overview of the equipment that can or cannot be used with lithium batteries, and I'll give you a few specific tips on what kind of software adjustments you might have to make, and I'll point out certain pros and cons of changing towards lithium batteries. Before we go ahead, let me introduce myself. My name is Jesse. I'm a renewable energy engineer, and I'm specialized in battery-based off-grid solar energy systems. I've run companies in the design and installation of off-grid systems and have held the position of energy officer for the United Nations. I founded the company Solar Solution, through which I share my knowledge and experience through videos such as this one, through seminars, online articles, and personal direct services on my website. In order to keep this video brief and focused, I'll cut up the information in four different sections. First, look at the DC-specific charging equipment and what kind of settings you should consider. The second section will briefly look at the overall monitoring system, the hardware and the settings that you should think about. We will look at inverters and inverter chargers, the hardware requirements and their settings. And in the last sections, we'll look at the pros and cons and what kind of gains you can expect if you actually change towards lithium. So let's start by looking at the actual DC charging equipment and their settings. So lead acid based batteries normally have a voltage of 12.6. And lithium iron phosphate batteries 12.8 volts. So there's a small difference here, and there are certain fine-tuning adjustment settings that you could consider for your system. We'll look at that later. But what is of great concern to me are the currents and your cable sizing. So if you'd be changing from a lead acid based battery bank towards lithium, now you know that you can discharge or charge much faster because lithium allows for much higher currents. But this also means that if you are going to change your discharge charge behavior, you should double check whether the wiring that is in place can actually accommodate for these increased currents. When we look at the way in which lithium batteries are charged, so the charging algorithm that controls the voltage and the amperage, it's important for you to realize that you really shouldn't overcharge lithium batteries. When they're full, you should stop charging. You know, something similar is true for lead acid batteries, but especially the flooded lead acid batteries. If you would overcharge them, it doesn't have a very dramatic effect on the battery. You would just start guessing a little bit more, so you lose a bit more electrolyte on average. So how do you make sure that you don't overcharge your lithium batteries? Well, this is fairly easily done by just making sure that your charging voltages are set correctly, especially for the absorption and float voltage. Now, with most modern equipment, including the inverted charge controllers and the solar and wind charge controllers, you can configure all these voltages. But it's important to realize that with certain alternators, for example, that these voltages are fixed. So you might be able to get away with this, but you have to double check whether these voltages comply with the voltages that you need to set for your lithium batteries. One last thing regarding the settings of your charging equipment. For conventional setups of charging equipment and lead acid based batteries, the charging equipment has a built-in temperature voltage correction factor, which means that as the equipment charges the battery and it senses that the temperature of the battery goes up or down, the equipment will also adjust the voltage accordingly. Now, for lithium batteries, this should not be done. So it is fairly easy to correct for this. So what you can do is go into the setting of your charging equipment, look up this temperature correction factor, and just set it to zero. And then it will not adjust the voltage as the temperature fluctuates. So now let's look at the equipment that you'll need for monitoring and protecting your system. So the term you'll often see is BMS, Battery Management System. Now, a BMS is strongly advised and it has strong advantages for using with a conventional lead acid system. But for lithium batteries, having a BMS is an absolute must. The reason for this is that if you would operate your lithium battery outside of the recommended specifications, then you would either create a dangerous situation or you would permanently damage your battery. So what the BMS will do is that it will disrupt operation if you would operate the battery on very high or low voltages, on very high or low temperatures, or if you'd exceed the preset amperage rating. An extra benefit of advanced BMS systems is that they'll often balance the individual cells. So what this means is that they'll look at all the small components of the battery and make sure that each and every component works just as hard as the other one. So for the reason that I've just explained, sometimes you'll see that the manufacturers will already include a BMS system inside of the battery, or they recommend that you buy the lithium battery together with their own made BMS system. When we look at the battery state of charge monitors that will tell you how full your battery is at a certain point in time, it's important to realize that the conventional cheaper models that work for lead acid batteries that only measure the voltage and then tell you how full the battery is will really not work for the lithium battery. So kind of the only proper option to go for with lithium is the ones that have a remote shunt close to the battery and then a monitor somewhere inside. And these measure the current going in and out and then calculate the state of charge based on that. So this brings us to the next section regarding the AC-DC inverters or inverter chargers. And there are three things I would like to mention here. Now the first one is a simple but very important one. So it's important that your inverter has a configurable, so an adjustable option for the LVD, the low voltage disconnect setting of the inverter. So what this means is that normally as the inverter draws more power from the battery, the voltage of the battery will drop. And at one point the inverter will say, okay, now I can see that the battery is pretty empty. So I'll stop taking power from the battery and I'll disconnect all the loads that are now taking power from me. Now, since the BMS system that we just talked about also does something similar, what you would want is that the inverter cuts off all the AC loads before the BMS inside of the battery or on top of the battery will cut off any kind of load. So for systems such as for RVs or boats, this would mean that if your battery drops below a certain point, your inverter will turn off, so you won't have any more AC power, but you still have 12 or 24 volt DC power coming from your battery for your most basic kind of equipment. The second thing is that if you have an inverted charger, then the same is true for the charger part of your inverted charger as what I discussed before about other charging systems. So you would want to be able to adjust the voltage of your absorption and float, and you want to make sure that you can adjust the temperature battery voltage correction factor to zero. The third and last one is a very simple one. If you have an inverter system which is relatively old and uses this simple voltage-based indicator system for telling you how full your battery is, so the state of charge of your battery, you know, the ones with the LED lights on top of next to each other with red, green and orange. If you have this and you would change towards lithium, this indicator will really not be reliable anymore. It will probably just tell you that the battery is full all the time. So this brings us to the last section, and I'll give you five different consequences, mostly positive, that you can expect if you start using lithium batteries. The first one is straightforward and pretty awesome. If you would change from lead acid to lithium and you would keep the same amount of storage capacity, you would accomplish a weight reduction of 60%. The second one is regarding the amount of energy storage that you get per the volume that it takes. It is also referred to as the energy density of a battery. Now, in theory, the energy density of lithium should be twice as much than that of lead acid. Though if you look in real life, the kind of batteries that you can get on the market, the energy density is kind of on the same level. But now if you would consider that lithium batteries, you can use almost all of the energy that's stored in the battery. You can draw it down to around 80 or 90%. If you compare this to lead acid based batteries, you can only use 50% of the energy. So then bottom line is that still lithium gives you 2 times the amount of energy density compared to conventional lead acid batteries. The next point is regarding the lifetime of lithium batteries. So if you would take the medium to high quality flooded lead acid batteries and compare them to the average lithium iron phosphate battery, then the lithium will give you approximately 25% more cycles, so 25% more lifetime. The challenge here is that while I was just comparing medium to high quality lead acid based batteries to lithium iron phosphate batteries, you know, in reality, the majority of the battery used in private setups is of very, very low quality. So if you'd compare those low quality lead batteries and compare them to the average lithium iron phosphate battery, then the lithium battery will give you 2 to 10 times more cycles, so 2 to 10 times more lifetime compared to the low quality lead acid based batteries. Number 4 is regarding the pricing of lithium batteries. So you can expect that you roughly spend 4 times the amount of money per unit of storage capacity if you compare lithium iron phosphate batteries to flooded lead acid batteries. So this also means that unfortunately it's still true that on average you'll spend more for using a lithium battery compared to the medium or high quality flooded lead acid batteries. Though on the bright side, if you do choose to go for lithium, your discharging and charging currents can be really high. Therefore, you can charge your battery really fast. You have way higher efficiencies over the whole charge and discharge cycle. And you should, on average, definitely get way more lifetime out of a lithium iron phosphate battery compared to the average lead acid battery. So now a question for you. If there's something else that you'd like to learn about off-grid energy systems, let me know in the comments below and I'll use this as inspiration to provide more videos for you and for others. Of course, remember, you've got all these great options. You can like, subscribe, share, you name it. I really hope that you enjoyed this video and I'll see you in the next one.